Americano, please.
Now used as a coffee stand, this vintage 1978 Barkas van might be the only truck or car we will see all afternoon. Hi, I'm Matt, and welcome to another edition of Borders on Budgets. On this episode, we are in Grodno, Belarus, and we will take a stroll down this town's pedestrian-only Sovetska Street. Well, this coffee and a brilliant sunny summer's afternoon on a Sunday will cure what's ailing me from what was a long night. Sheep, elephant, fox. And where do you get these ideas from?
I get ideas from my head.
Good!
Покажи пальчик.
Красотка.
Или вот, допустим, тюльпанчик не нравится. Это было. Да, тут все мыло.
А эти четыре рубли.
Well, we have soap in the shape of caviar on toast. Well, nothing like starting the morning scrubbing yourself and then smelling like fish eggs. While most of the street vendors on Sovetska Street are preferring the shade on this warm afternoon, I like how this painter has displayed his works in the brilliant, illuminating sun. And it's this natural light that really shows off the detail of these works. The city of Grodno has been in existence for over 1,000 years, and historically had been the third most important city in the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth. However, it has only been in the past couple of years that the town, and by extension the country, has opened itself up to visitors. As Europe's last remaining dictatorship, Belarus has had its borders somewhat closed to outsiders, though in the past couple of years it has extended visa-free status to the city of Minsk and the borderlands, such as here in Grodno, because it is in Grodno that it is closest to Poland and Lithuania in the northwest corner of Belarus.
Hello.
I like the design of these garbage cans. Below the enlarged city map, the paintings are from the artist Luba, and she, as a local, she has some information about how to properly say the city's name. So it's not Grodno, it is, how is it pronounced?
Royal City.
So it's Grodno.
Grodno.
And that is the Belarusian pronunciation.
Yes, it is Belarusian pronunciation.
Okay.
Hrodna.
So there it is. It is Hrodna, though on English maps we will see it as Grodno, which is the Russian pronunciation. In the windows of many stores along Sovetska Street are colorful yet grim reminders of the sacrifices Belarus made during the Second World War. Whatever your thoughts are about the Soviet Union, past Soviet Union, and communism in general, it can't be forgotten the suffering that occurred in Eastern Europe, particularly here in Belarus. Had Germany been successful in victory, they let it be known that they would have killed or enslaved tens of millions of Russians, Belarusians, and other Slavic peoples. So yes, Belarus and its population were fighting for its very survival during the Great Patriotic War. How's business today? Okay, what seems to be the hubbub on this corner? Ooh, bunny!
It's our magic rabbit.
A magic rabbit?
A magic rabbit. He lives in the castle?
Yes. Bunny! Besides the rabbit showing off his domain of the castle, for sale are magical predictions for 20 kopeck, or about 10 cents.
За вашу веру в волшебство одарят вас невидимым чувством с легкостью.
Magical prediction. That's a doctoral thesis.
Проблемы.
This is the other end of Sovetska Street. That it should have a Burger King and an upscale mall suggests that Belarus, while it has its domestic and international challenges, it is beginning to welcome the public and foreigners for both tourism and investment. Thank you for tuning in to another edition of Borders on Budgets. A reminder, Borders on Budgets, long distance hikes, slices of life, not a lot of money. From Grodno, or as it is pronounced in Belarusian, Hrodna, Belarus, thank you for tuning in, and I look forward to seeing you on the next episode.
National dancing, and they are very easy for people. We said that everyone who has two legs and can go and walk can dance. It's easy.
Say, did you like this episode? Good. Help Borders on Budgets. Hit the subscribe button below and help Borders on Budgets grow. In the meantime, don't forget to send this video to your friends who like rabbits and offbeat travel.